Since Android Wear devices are worn by the user, they're an ideal platform to implement fitness applications. These types of applications typically use sensors on the device to measure step counts, acceleration, and position. The good news is that Android Wear uses exactly the same sensor API as regular Android phones and tablets, so you can reuse all your existing knowledge about sensors here as well. Let's look at a sample to see how it works. A good one is called Jumping Jack, so let's create a project around that and test it. In this case, I'm going to use a real watch to test it out and show you how it works. Right now, it has a zero on the counter shown in the activity. So let's do a few jumping jacks. One, two, three. And now you can see that it's counted the values correctly. So what is different about working with sensors on Android Wear? Well, the main differences come down to saving battery power and not doing too much processing on the wearable device. Let's go through some best practices for sensors on Android Wear. You want to do as little work as possible, so unregister your listener when you don't need it. For a running app, we only want to log steps when the user is running the actual activity. For the rest of the day when the activity is not running, we should put the device to sleep and use the standard watch face, saving power. The next thing is to select an appropriate update rate. If you're only going to refresh the display every minute, then there's no point getting updates 10 times per second. And you might also want to request that the results are batched up over this time period so that the CPU can stay asleep the whole time. The RegisterListener method allows you to control these factors. Also, make sure if you need to process the data, try to do as much on the phone as possible. Remember, the phone has a huge battery compared to the little wearable here, so take advantage of that. If you're trying to measure the bumpiness of a car ride, and you know the wearable user has their phone with them, why not use the accelerometer in the phone to do the logging instead of the wearable? The GPS feature in Android Wear does exactly this. If you have the phone and the wearable in close proximity, it will actually use the phone's GPS unit. If the wearable goes out on a run while the phone stays at home, and if the device has a GPS built in, it'll use the GPS from the wearable. There is a sample for this called Speed Tracker. Check it out for yourself and see how it's implemented. One new sensor that was introduced in KitKat phones and available on all wearables is the StepCounter. This is really useful for fitness applications and is a low power sensor you can use often. It is also a lot more efficient than trying to build your own StepCounter by reading the accelerometers. The Android StepCounter is provided by dedicated hardware. You'll notice in the documentation there is a type step detector and a type step counter. The detector is configured to trigger every time a step is made, but it's possible that you'll not receive the events if the device is sleeping. You also don't want to have the device wake up and run your code after every single step, like at these points here, especially if you only want to refresh the display every minute. So the step counter here is a much better idea. It gives you an absolute value, so your code does not need to wake up on every step. And you cannot miss any steps because you always get the absolute value each time.